Today I will tell you how to solve Scissorlink loop-the-loop puzzles in easy way. First of all, let me tell you the rules. First and foremost rule is there will only be a one loop in all the puzzle. There cannot be more than one loop. If you are making more than one loop, then something is wrong. One more thing that whatever the numbers are written here denotes that there can be that number of lines around it. Suppose this is one, then around this four edges only one line will be drawn. But another thing is for three, there will be three lines. Similarly, if it is zero, then there will not be any lines around it. Okay. And another thing is this, that there cannot be any branches. For example, if you have drawn lines around two like this, and there are two lines are here, so there cannot be another line from here. This is not allowed because this will create a branch. And similarly, this cannot be left open-ended as hanging. Similarly, this one also. So we have to keep in mind these aspects of solving the Scissorlink puzzle. And now we will start. But before we start, let me tell you that there can be seven lines, up to seven lines, and seven columns. So this kind of puzzle is called 7x7 Scissorlink loop-the-loop puzzle. There can be other forms also, but 7x7 is most popular one, loop-the-loop puzzle. So let us solve it. So we have to start solving from zero. Around zero there will not be any lines. Okay. So if you proceed here from zero, you have to remember everything is to be done logically. There cannot be anything illogical things. So zero cannot have lines here. So for this three, remaining three has to be filled up. Okay. So let us fill up three lines. Similarly, around these three lines, this has to be continued. And this has to continue like this because there cannot be any loose ends. You continue like this up to this point. Why? Because there cannot be any line coming from here, because to avoid the branches. Now two has only one logical remaining lines, so we can draw a line here because there cannot be any line here and a line here. So you just continue. This two has one line here and another line is possible. It is not possible here. So it is possible here only. Okay. And another thing is three is also available here and two is also available here. This two can have line here and no other option is possible. So we will draw line here for this two. Okay. Another thing, we have to continue this as three cannot have line here, so other three branches are to be filled up, and this has to be continued thus to fulfill the condition of two. And these three cannot have a line here, so we will draw line for three here and here. Okay. Yeah. Similarly, these three cannot have a line here, so remaining three has to be filled up. Remaining three are these. Okay, this line cannot have a loose end, so this has to be continued this way. This cannot be continued this way because if you continue this way, this end will be loose end. Okay, so we have only option here available is we have to draw a line up to this point. So this will be the complete one. Okay. And we can continue here because the continuity and making the three lines. And this is three lines of this three is completed. So with this cannot be drawn here. So you have to go up. This is here. These two cannot have a line here and here. So only possibility is this. Everything has to be done logically. Nothing illogical you have to do. Okay. So this two has completed these two lines, but one has also completed one line here. So remaining three lines are not possible because one can have only one line. So it has to be extended further because one cannot have more than one line around it. This is not possible. This is have to go above. Now we have to look at this three because here a line cannot be drawn, so three has to be have line around this case. Yeah. So we can draw a line here. Okay. This cannot have a loose ends, this one, so the only option available is to be drawn here. So this is completed. Okay, so we have to go draw it here. It cannot go right side. So we have to draw further and we have to stop here. Okay. Now we have to apply some logic that how to proceed further. These two cannot have a line here and here. So only option available for these two is here. So we will go here. Now for this three, this is the open end, so remaining these two lines has to be filled up. Now this end has to go up because no other option. And this has to further extended from here. It cannot come down as branches cannot be there, so we have to extend further and we have to stop here, but not stop here because one has completed its one edge. Thus we have to go further because it cannot come down, so it will come up to this point. Okay, now we have to think of some other logic here. One of the logic here is this two is remaining here and this two cannot have a line here because of the branch cannot come here from here, and similarly this. So only option available with two are these two lines. So we will draw these two lines. See. Similarly for these two, same condition is there. Only possible T's are these two lines. So we will draw these two lines. This cannot have a loose end, so it has to be extended here. This cannot be extended this way because zero cannot have any lines around it, so it has to go up. Now now we don't have any logic here except 3. Since 3, this line has no option, so it has to go up. So everything here has to be logically. This line cannot be extended here because there cannot be any branches. So only option available is this. So we have drawn this line. Now these two can have only these two lines available. So we have to draw these two lines. Now we have to see how our puzzle completes. So here we have options here. We can join these two lines. Then 2 will have one line here and extend this line here. Then we have two lines here. For one, only option available will be this line. So after completing this line also, and 3, as 3 has 3 lines, so we'll complete here like this. We'll go and we can go here and we'll join here. So one will also complete here the line. So it will complete the puzzle. Okay. So we are here. This is our logic. So this is, let us join here. And now this two has 2 lines, one has 1 line, and this 3. This cannot be extended, this line cannot be extended here, because if we extend here, we have to go up here, and one will have 1 line here and 1 line here. So we don't have any option but to go up. And let's join this one. So we have complete. We have completed this puzzle. This is the whole puzzle completion procedure. What I told you, that nothing can be random here. Everything will be logical. You have to go logical way and you will find your solution easily. And always start with the 0, and it is best to start with the 0.